Alright, open up to 9.4.
Got it. Page 511.
511, thank you. Alright, today we are finally going to start graphing the inequalities that we've been working on. Okay? I want you to look at the essential question and think for about a minute or two and come up with what today's learning target should be. What is today's goal? What do you need to know by the end of today? Timmy.
How to use the table's values to graph the relationship.
Okay. Word that with a we can. Or we will be
able to use the table's values to graph the relationships.
Absolutely. We will be able to
use the table's values to graph the relationship.
Use the table values. So the relationships between quantities? Jaden, what do you want to add to that?
He actually finished what I wanted to say.
Oh, you were going to say between quantities? Okay. Anybody want to add to that? We will be able to use the table values to graph the relationships between quantities. Sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's work.
Why do you need to do this? Jack?
Because we're making cookies, or because we're making chocolate. And we need to add this many eggs with this flour and this milk.
Okay. How are we going to word that for our daily target? Because it's not always about cookies. I mean, I love cookies, but it's not always about cookies. So in order to graph it, we need to look at the table. It's going to give us ordered pairs. The ordered pairs, as we did in the previous chapter, will tell you where your point will go on the graph, right? So let's look at the ordered pairs. Where are they coming up with this 1, 200? Hannah. every 1 hour, 200 pancakes can be made. My dad can do way more than that. And he's not a machine.
Why is the cafeteria pancakes
machine? Okay, so for every 2 hours, how many pancakes will be made?
400.
Did you really need to look at the table for that?
No.
No, because why?
Because you're just multiplying it by 2.
Because we're multiplying it by 2.
We're adding 200.
Next one. For every 3 hours.
600.
How many for 4 hours? Alicia? 5 hours?
1,000.
Okay, each one of these ordered pairs is a point on your graph. Okay, keep that in mind. You're not always going to be given the table, correct? Sometimes it will ask you to make, not the table, sorry, the graph. Sometimes it will ask you to make the graph. It is your job to decide what scale you're going to follow. What numbers should go on the side. Okay? You don't want to use 1, right? Because our lowest number is 200. You'd have to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, all the way up to 200. Okay? So which scale, how are we going to count to make this graph make sense? We're going to count by 200. Why not? You look at your table. Each one of those numbers are a multiple of 200. But yes, also a multiple of 2. Or multiples of 200. So we'll start with 200. 200, 400, 600, 800, 1,000. Okay, notice how they give you a space in between. If we were graphing other things, they could go in between. If somehow we got 500, where would 500 go? Kendra.
In between 600.
Yeah. Okay? You have that space in between. It tells the people looking at the graph something could go in between. Okay? Give you space. Right?
Yes.
All right, so our first order pair told us. Oh, sorry, we gotta do the bottom. Are we gonna count by 4 hours at a time?
No.
What are we gonna count by?
Once,
because that's the increment we're using, right?
Yeah.
220. At 2 hours, how many pancakes?
400.
So I need to.
Triple sugar.
Right. So they already did the table for us. We're going to write the ordered pairs. At 0 hours, how many bicycles did they have left?
10.
10. At 1 hour, how many were left?
8.
Skips 2. At 3 hours, how many were left?
4.
4.
At 4 hours, how many were left?
2.
I heard a lot of you saying 6 for the unknown one. Mm-hmm. How were you able to figure that out? Sam.
I figured it out because I saw the pattern and she keeps coming down by 2. So if for 2 hours, if for 1 hour or 8, you just subtract that by 2. And then 2, it would be 6.
So what does that tell you about the number of bicycles they assemble in an hour?
That they assemble 2 each hour?
Absolutely. So now we have to graph it. Explain that.
Because a proportional relationship has to go through its origin.
Explain that.
How do I explain it?
You tell us. This is something you're doing in 7th grade math, right?
Well, I think it's doing it in here.
So explain it. Anna? Are you going to explain this proportional relationship thing? I think that's in the upcoming chapter. So I'm not going to throw that at everybody yet. Okay? Good job, though. Nice connection. Alright, do you graph it? Who would like to graph it? Graph it. Graph it. Caitlin! How'd she do?
She have one for the second? Two.
We already did this part. Okay, it wants to know the unknown value for y. You guys found the pattern. They were doing 2 an hour. So for 2 hours of work, how many bicycles did they have left to assemble?
6.
You guys told me it wasn't going to be in a straight line. I mean, it's not a straight line because I can't draw a straight line this time, but. Alright, so this next part you're going to do share and show on your own. When you are done, I want you to find a partner and compare answers. Okay? Just find the next person who is done. Compare answers, then raise your hands, I'll come check them for you, and then I'll tell you where to go from there. Alright?
Cool.
Yeah. You should be done within the next 12 minutes.
Thank you.
does anybody have any, like, hardcore pressing questions about how to graph these? This part's kind of hard to word right now, right? Because we want to say so that we can bake cookies and know how many cookies are
successful in the real world.
But how do we make this more universal so it applies to more than just cookies?
Wait, yeah. So, if you have to keep track of like your money in the bank or whatever, it's like the numbers of like a month, and you could graph how much money you get a month.
Okay, so that's another situation. But what's the overall word that we're looking for?
Keeping track of.
Tell me what you think about this word.
It's that quantities.
We can apply it in real world situations. We can apply in real world situations. We can apply. Okay, because you guys have great situations. Jack talked about making cookies. Caitlin's talked about tracking your money when you're older. Jake.
Speed and time, like kind of like an airplane, you calculate miles per hour to the hour and miles.
Speed and time. I actually do this when I go on road trips because I hate being in the car. So I like to know how long it's going to take me at a certain speed.
Oh, so you ride a bike?
No way. Yes.
How much money you spend each year?
Yeah, absolutely. Grown-ups probably do that when it comes to trying to save money for a trip or something along those lines. Jane?
Never mind.
Ooh, interest in a savings account. How do you know about that?
Taxes?
Maybe. I don't understand taxes too well to be able to tell you anything about it. I just know that when it's tax season, I give my mom my taxes and then there's money making.
You get 6% sales tax.
Okay. If you are done with the share and show and on your own, you need to go on to problem solving. Okay? Let me know when you see.